Don't take the lady's water.
It's all right, Mr. Schuster. I've got plenty.
Nobody's got plenty.
Oh, Mr. Schuster, I thought I heard your voice.
For the last time, Mrs. Bronson, we're leaving.
Did you get gas?
I got 12 gallons. I figure that ought to get us at least to Syracuse.
Where are you going?
To Toronto. We're trying to get to Toronto. Mr. Schuster has a cousin there.
You know, I'm not so sure it's wise you're trying to do this. The highways are packed, bumper to bumper, the radio says. And what with the gas shortage and everything.
I know that, but we've got to try anyway. It's been nice living here. You're good neighbors. Let's go, honey.
Bye.
Good luck. Safe trip. And now we are two.
They were the last?
Building's empty now. Except for you and me.
What happens now?
I don't know. I heard on the radio that they're only going to turn the water on an hour a day from now on. They said they'd announce what time. Aren't you going to leave?
No. No, I'm not going to leave. You know, Mrs. Bronson, I keep getting this crazy thought. This crazy thought that I'm going to wake up and none of this will have happened. I'll wake up in a cool bed. It'll be night outside. And there'll be a wind. Branches rustling. Shadows on the sidewalk. A moon. Traffic noises. Automobiles. Garbage cans. Milk bottles. And voices.
There was a scientist on the radio this morning. He said that it'll get a lot hotter more each day, now that we're moving so close to the sun. And that's why we're... That's why...
The word that Mrs. Bronson is unable to put into the hot, still, sodden air is doomed. Because the people you've just seen have been handed a death sentence. 1 month ago, the Earth suddenly changed its elliptical orbit, and in doing so, began to follow a path which gradually, moment by moment, day by day, took it closer to the sun. And all of man's little devices to stir up the air are now no longer luxuries. They happen to be pitiful and panicky keys to survival. The time is 12:05, midnight. There is no more darkness. The place is New York City, and this is the eve of the end. Because even at midnight, it's high noon, the hottest day in history, and you're about to spend it in the Twilight Zone.